All right, so as we do here on the show, this is The Five. Now, Kenya's Private Sector Alliance has been conducting some surveys of its members throughout the COVID-19 period to understand the impact of the pandemic on businesses and how effective the interventions have been, as well as gauging outlook for the months to come. Now, this one is the fourth survey that was conducted between September and October this year. It attracted 428 respondents from all sectors of the economy. We've picked some key five highlights from that survey. Now, regarding the issue of business closures, 50% of the businesses that were surveyed had remained open throughout. Now, that means there's another half that didn't, while 37% of the ones that had closed reopened during this period. Now, the second biggest issue was that of job losses. How many were able to keep their employees? Well, 58% of the businesses retained their employees. That means there were about 42% that had to let go of some of their employees. Most of the layoffs were reported in the micro, small, and medium-sized firms, mostly in the tourism, construction, and education sectors. Just going again to prove that the MSME sector was and has been hardest hit. Now, for those that let go of their employees, only 59% were able to offer them severance packages. And then we have the 4% that hired, and these were in the sectors of manufacturing, energy, and professional sectors. Now, beyond retrenchments, many of the businesses had to make some other cutbacks. 70% of them reduced expenditure on non-core business activities. Close to half of others suspended any new investments and expansion plans, and others adopted e-commerce. Now, you may also remember there was a raft of economic government interventions that were announced by the president to mitigate the effects of the pandemic. Well, according to the survey, the businesses that responded to that survey, they said there was some effectiveness of these measures. 48% reported that the reduction of VAT had been most helpful to them. Another 38% were grateful for the payee reduction, while 35% listed the reduction of corporate tax as being most helpful to them. Now, that is the past. When we take a look into the future, 43% of the respondents expect a full recovery in 2021, and another 24% said they expect full recovery in 2022. There was 8%, a mere 8%, who expect full recovery by the end of this year. That's just about a month and a half from now. But this is another interesting one that we all need to be paying attention to, and it's one that's most urgent. 21% are not sure whether their organizations will ever fully recover. And we'll be talking about what that means for them. Now, when it comes to seeing a silver lining, there were some that actually saw a silver lining through the crisis, right? 35% reported seeing new opportunities in online platforms and in the manufacturing of new products. So that is The Five regarding the business sector and the economy right now, 9 months into.